Muslim women who refuse to remove their headscarves for police may instead be fingerprinted. A Sydney woman yesterday successfully appealed a court conviction on the grounds police couldn't be sure what she looked like.
Carnita Matthews left court yesterday victorious. But the reaction from the Premier today, laws need to be tougher.
I'm happy to back police proposals or any police measure to strengthen those laws.
The furor over Muslim headscarves started when Ms Matthews was pulled over by police 2 years ago. Asked to remove her veil to confirm her identity, she let loose.
You are racist. Okay. All cops are racist.
Ms Matthews was later charged with falsely accusing an officer after claiming he forcibly removed her veil. But yesterday the case was thrown out. Police couldn't prove she made the complaint because the woman who did was wearing a veil.
It's not my client's fault that the Parliament hasn't enacted laws to suit the situation she's in.
The case has sparked renewed calls for burqas to be banned.
I don't believe it's part of our culture, no. And it's not part of the Muslim religion either.
I don't support bans on clothing, but equally, I don't support unfounded accusations of racism.
It would be very helpful if politicians would show some leadership and stop looking at issues that divide us and look at issues that unite us.
Police say the laws governing full-face coverings are confusing. Officers can demand to see a person's driver's licence, but they can't force the same person to remove religious headscarves to confirm they are who they say they are.
The police minister wants laws amended.
To ensure that where there is uncertainty at the scene, police have the ability to take the person back and to be able to check their identity.
Andrew Denny, 10 News.